Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we'll take a look at the recently released Outlook 2016 preview on the desktop. We'll show the new Outlook Mail and Calendar apps for Windows 10 phone and tablets, and we'll round out our cross-platform story by showing you Outlook for iOS and Android. Again by Ben Walters. So Ben, what are we doing to innovate on email, and what's the significance behind the recent announcements?
So email is still the number one way that people work today. We have hundreds of millions of users across all of our platforms, including Outlook, Exchange, and Office 365. And what we really want to do is make sure that mail experience is great no matter what device you're on.
So we have a Windows PC here. Why don't we start with Windows and say what's new for Outlook for the desktop?
So Outlook 2016 will be the richest experience on a desktop to date. You'll see improvements in our support for cloud files, more effective search, and deeper integration with features across Office 365. So let me show you what some of these look like.
Okay.
As we open up Outlook 2016, you'll notice we have this new personality theme, which means that we have a blue bar across the top of Outlook, matching the logo and the theming that we have for Outlook. We've also included a new dark theme for people on really bright monitors that gives a little bit more contrast and just makes it a bit easier on the eyes. As I move into creating new emails, we've also made some improvements in the way you work with attachments. So as we share attachments historically, we usually have to go and find a deep path and browse through our PC to find that. But now what we have is we've integrated the most recently used items list directly into the attached dialog. So as I click on attachments, you can see I get a list of all the files I've been recently working on. You'll also notice that some of these files are located on my C drive, so on my local PC here, and the ones with the cloud icon are actually located in my OneDrive for Business. And so as I click on those links, you'll notice I get an attachment directly to my OneDrive, and this is actually a link through to the file. And you'll also notice that we've given edit rights to those people. So as I'm sharing files for collaboration, I'm providing those permissions over to the people that I'm putting in the to line.
Right, and looking forward, can we also expect that you'll be able to share permissions for a file maybe that's stored on your C drive if you want to share that out centrally?
Yeah, definitely. As we move forward into our tech preview and make updates, we really want to see those files on the PC get up to OneDrive to Business and stored in a central place for collaboration.
Great, so what else can you show us?
So one of the other integrations we have with Outlook 2016 is we've brought Clutter from the Outlook web app down to the rich client.
Okay.
And Clutter is a way for machine learning to take the way you work with email and move that email into a inbox or a separate folder so you don't have to focus on it as soon as you need to. So what you'll see here is I have a Clutter folder and I have all of this email coming through, and I want to be able to teach my machine learning what's important and what's not. So my holiday party recipe here, I'm going to right click that, and as I come down in my interface in my right click menu, you can see I have a move to Clutter button. And what this does is pushes that email out to my Clutter folder and teaches the machine learning for next time to move that around.
And these are just a few highlights for the Outlook client, right?
That's right. We also have new support for groups coming into the rich client, and we'll also have support for OAuth as we move forward, which enables these great multi-factor authentication scenarios.
So this is really great stuff if you've got a mouse and a keyboard, but what if I'm on the go with Windows 10 on a phone or a tablet? What improvements are we making there?
Look, we've been hard at work on the email experience for phone and small tablets that are running Windows 10. The first thing you'll notice on this new version of Outlook Mail for Windows 10 is that the experience is really, really different to what we had on Windows 8. And that's because we designed this from the ground up for Windows 10. You'll see as well that it's really familiar to those people who've worked on Outlook before. So you'll notice we still have a folder pane on the left-hand side and our message inbox and message pane on the right as well. So really easy for people to pick up and use. But the improvements go beyond just the look and feel. We've created a much richer authoring experience, and we've taken advantage of all the functionality that we have in Word and put that into the editing experience as well. So as I create a new email here, you'll notice I have all of the format controls, insert, all of those, you know, features and things that I have in Word today in my editing experience for email.
So that's the authoring experience, but what about triage in your email?
Well, look, when we think about touch, we've got some great functionality that comes in as part of that. And when we think about triaging, we have these new swipe gestures that we can use within the application so that we can very quickly go through and set flags or delete emails, or we can even customize those swipes so we can move it to other folders or do archiving as well. So really easy for me to be able to triage those messages quickly.
And it's easy to get back to your calendar as well, right?
That's right. So we have a calendar link right down the bottom here, which will take me straight into the calendar view of what's going on, where my schedule's at. And when we look at the calendar, we've got a whole bunch of new things in there as well. So you can see I've got all of my, currently my US holidays and birthdays and appointments in there. But we've also got things like being able to pinch zoom into weeks and then into days as well. So I can really start to get a view as to what's happening and really easily navigate through that calendar experience.
So here we're connected to Outlook.com, but I know other services can be connected to with this app as well, right?
That's right. So we have support for anyone running Exchange or Office 365, and we also have Exchange for IMAP and POP and other providers as well, like Yahoo and Gmail.
This is great to see, but what else is coming?
So we have some great new features coming as well. With Cortana on Windows 10, you'll be able to instruct Cortana to do things like send emails and schedule meetings for you on your behalf.
So beyond Windows, we also launched Outlook for iOS and Android. So Ben, can you give us a quick look at the new capabilities of those apps?
Sure. So earlier this year, we released an Outlook app for iOS and a preview version of this app for Android. What we found was that a lot of people tend to use first-party applications on their phone, which is great for triaging email, but really keeps them waiting until they get back to a PC to do full work and really work with that inbox. Mm-hmm. So what we've done with these apps is created a way for them to manage their inbox effectively while they're on the go. So if I open up my new Outlook for iOS app, there's a couple of things you'll notice first of all. First off, we have these two tabs of email. So I have a focus tab and an other tab. And this is a way for Outlook to be able to filter my mail down to the things that are important to me, making it really easy for me to see what I need to respond to and the things that it can probably wait till later for me to follow up on.
Yeah.
One of the other areas that is great with when working with Outlook is this idea of swipe gestures. So as I'm triaging my email, it's really easy for me to swipe from the right to the left or left to right and have these actions of ways I can work with my mail. Now, of course, a phone and working with mail is very personal as well. So as we come over to settings, we can also see that I can actually go and customize those swipe options to suit the way I triage my email as well. So it's really easy for this to work the way I work as opposed to the way the app thinks I should work. You'll also notice that if I do this schedule action on my swipe, we have this ability to take an email and push this out till later on. So if I decide I want to schedule this for tomorrow morning, the mail leaves my inbox, but will actually pop in at the top of my inbox later on when I need to follow that up.
That's really great. So beyond that, I can also manage my calendar there, right?
That's right. So we have direct calendar integration into the app. And usually calendars sit in a separate application on the device, which means when I want to start to see what my schedule looks like and where I need to be, I need to close my mail app down and bring that back up. And this also creates these amazing new experiences for me. So as I go and create a new email, if I want to schedule a meeting with someone, for example, it's really easy for me to be able to create that invite and see when I'm available and what time is free for me to do that. Mm-hmm. Alternately, I could also share my availability. Again, this is usually something we spend a lot of time switching between apps to look at. But here it's really easy for me to set my availability, come down, just select the times that I want to be able to be free. And then if I hit done, you'll notice we go and format into the email ready to share. One of the other areas that's been great within this application is centralizing all of my attachments and cloud storage. So at the bottom here, I have this files link, and this gives me a view of all the files that are sitting in my cloud storage today, both from attachments in email and also my cloud service providers. So OneDrive, Dropbox, all of the major providers can be added in there, so I have a central place to do that. And if I want to share files from my OneDrive with people, I simply select those, and the app takes care of setting up those permissions for me as well.
Well, that's excellent. So this is very integrated with all the cloud services, and really you see here with the phone, we're able to do things that we traditionally had to use the desktop to do in terms of triaging mail, sending calendars, setting up meetings, all of those types of things.
That's right. And what I've shown you is just the first step. We're continuing to iterate quickly to bring new features to Outlook. And in the coming months, we'll deliver more integration with Office 365 and improvements in security, management, and compliance controls.
Excellent. So how do I get access to all of these applications?
So Outlook for iOS and Android are available on the App Store and Google Play today. Outlook Mail for Windows 10 will be built into phones and tablets running Windows 10. So to get the preview, you're going to want to try that out. Outlook 2016 is part of the Office 2016 preview on Connect.
These are really great updates for Outlook across devices. Of course, all this news and more can be found on the Office Blogger. Catch us Wednesdays or as news breaks on Office Mechanics. Thanks for watching and goodbye for now.